Hello students, welcome to the class. I'm Yogita. Our subject is nutrition, nutrition for nurses. And today we are going to learn about that food group. We already learned that there are two groups, 11 group system and 5 group system. So let me begin with this 11 group system. In that first, cereals and millets. Now here, if you see Indian system or all over the world, 75% of our diet is mainly because of cereals or millets. It's also because that it's easily available, also cheap. Mainly with the people with a low socioeconomic status, yeah, developing countries, they are depending on these cereals. Now, what's the difference between cereals and millets? Now, rice and wheat, they are mainly called as cereals. Rest all these cereals are called as millets because they are small in size. Ragi, jowar, maza, maize, bajra, oats, these all are called millets. Now here, the cereals where you cannot remove the skin and use that, such items are called as millets. So the total example of cereals and millets are rice, wheat, barley, oats, jowar, maize, bajra and ragi. So the composition of nutrition value here, they are mainly providing the calories, 3.5 kilocalorie per gram. Also, the cereals and millets will provide a rich source of carbohydrates. They are providing energy to the individual. Also, they contain certain minerals and some B complex vitamin. Now, the cereals and millets are the poor source of calcium. You don't get any calcium in that. But apart from that, we are getting lot of energy. So, this is about your cereals and millets. The second group was legumes. We also known it also known as pulses. Now see, as how I said that we are eating major portion of cereals, rice or chapati, but still they are not rich in protein, but still we are not finding any protein deficiency. Why? Because we are using pulses there. We are making some pulses curry and we are eating, for example, rice and sambar with vegetables and pulses, chapati and some dal curry or dal bati churma, dal fry, or you're making channa masala. See, lot of curries, definitely around 50 to 60% of our diet that constitute pulses. Now, again here when we have the split pulses, that that specially called as dal. Now, that example of these pulses are grams, Bengal gram, green gram, black gram and horse gram, red gram. Beans, like soya bean, green beans. So these are the important examples of legumes or pulses. Now the nutritive values are calorie. Now pulses will provide 3.5 calorie per gram. Now they also provide energy. They are rich in protein, so that we will not have any protein deficiency when we eat pulses in a major quantity in our diet. But they contain a very less lipid. Also, they contain some minerals, calcium, around 200 mg per 100 gram. Now, these pulses are rich in vitamin B complex. Now, soya bean is a rich source of protein. It also called as poor man protein. One who is not taking any non-vegetarian, definitely they are able to meet all the need of protein with the help of soya bean. So, next category, third group is nuts and oil seeds. Now, nuts means some of the dry fruits. These are fruits which is dried, that also called as nuts, or else some which has got a shell. Now, for example, we are having almond, pista, cashew nut, groundnut, coconut, sesame seeds, cotton seeds, sunflower seeds and soya bean seeds. They all are nuts and seeds. Now, we can also extract oil from these seeds. You may know it. We are having almond oil, coconut oil, sunflower oil, which is good for health. You might have seen a lot of advertisements. So, we are extracting oil from these seeds. Now, the nutritive value composition is, they are rich in fat. Nearly 40 to 60% of such unsaturated fatty acids we can see here in these oils. Then also, they are rich in protein, carbohydrates and minerals, some B complex in a limit. Next is a fourth group, vegetable. Now, nothing to explain. What we get from the plants are fresh vegetables. They are make a 30 to 40% of our diet. So when we make a balanced diet, definitely we are including these vegetables. Now, vegetables are fresh green leafy vegetables, root-shaped tubers, and other vegetables. Now, green leafy vegetables like spinach, cabbage, cauliflower, coriander, all those. Now, roots are sweet potato, carrot, beetroot, radish. Now, other vegetables like brinjal, cucumber, bitter gourd, pumpkin, tomato. If I list out, we can find lot of vegetables. Also, with the same vegetable, we can prepare a different kind of variety of dishes. For example, you take potato, we can make aloo potato, aloo paneer, aloo matar. And what else? Many ingredients, many items we can prepare. Now, here, these green leafy vegetables are rich in vitamins. Also, we should make a note that these vitamins, what we present, is water soluble. So, you must take it when you use all these vegetables, because if you wash thoroughly or if you overcook, all these vitamins get lost with this water. Fine. Now, green leafy vegetables, we can also note that they're rich in vitamin A. And roots and tubers are rich in starch, and other vegetables are rich in a different kind of vitamins as well as minerals. Fine. Fifth category is fruits. Yeah, now I don't need to explain much because you may know all the fruits. A for apple, B for banana, C for, yes, keep on telling. Okay, now these fruits are, it's available fresh in our nature. Examples like banana, mango, orange, sweet lime, papaya, grapes, chiku, pineapple, and berry, strawberry, mulberry, all the other berries. Okay. Now, the nutritive value of these fruits. Now, fruits are rich source of vitamins. If you see vitamin C, it's rich in lemon. Even for the cold, yeah, common cold, your flu, we are using these orange lemons. Now, they are also rich in carbohydrates, rich in vitamin A, all the other vitamins. Each food item we can differentiate with a different kind of vitamins. Now, also, these fresh fruits are the good source of potassium and fiber. Then these waters, okay. Now these fruits, they also contain water bodies, so that this also help us to maintain the water balance in our body. Okay, the sixth group is milk and milk product. Definitely we have a unique place for milk in our life. From the infant till the old age adult, everyone likes milk and they love to drink milk. Now definitely milk is not only one form. With the help of milk, we can prepare a different milk products. We can make curd, ghee, cheese, butter, many things. Even paneer, everything can be prepared with the help of milk. So that different preparations will provide all different kind of requirements, nutrient values. So milk is a whole product which provide all kind of vitamins, minerals, nutrients, almost everything present in that. All the nutrient values are present in milk. Now also, milk also provide a considerable amount of protein, fat, carbohydrates. Among minerals, they have calcium, phosphate, as well as they are rich in vitamin A and B complex, poor in ascorbic acid. So milk is also, yes, it's a good source of protein. So this is all about milk. I don't need to explain much because we all are making use of milk in a day-to-day life. The next, seventh one is egg. So egg is, when I say about egg, definitely we are talking about the hen's egg which we consume. So if you consume a whole egg, definitely that's really good for health. Now this egg has contained two parts, white color and yellow color yolk. Now white color constitutes around 60% of egg, and that remaining 40% is made up of this yellow color yolk. Now again, this egg also contain all kind of nutrient except carbohydrate and vitamin C. Other than these two, rest all the nutrients what we can see in eggs. Next is animal food. Now if I say about animal food, we can say meat, fish because different source, land and water origin, we can get different type of foods which is purely based on animal origin. Now when we see the meat, here it is cattle meat, beef, pork, chicken. Commonly we are using chicken, but rest there are other type of meat is used by different kind of people. Okay, now the different chemical, nutritional composition of this meat is, meat is a rich source of energy. It is a rich source of protein, as well as it also have some content of carbohydrate. It also include fat and minerals for up to 5%. And meat like liver, kidney, rich in protein and vitamin B12. So definitely we all are eating meat. But only the thing is that meat, whatever you eat, it takes little long time to digest. So you need to give a little pause when you had a heavy meals with meat. And also drink plenty of water so that we will have an easy digestion process. Now next is fish. It's one of the seafood. It's a sea water source is an important source that we are getting fish. Now we can have a fresh fish. Also this fish can be dried, so that we can use it as a dry fish. Now, this fish is also available from fresh water or that sea water. Now here, for example, we can have a different type of fish like sardines, mackerels, hilsa, variety of shellfish. It also available shellfish. Now the nutritional value is, it's depending on the source, like how we are getting it. Now, main source of protein, they contain 115 to 20% and their rich source of carbohydrates also is there. And also, they contain essential fatty acids. Fish contain essential fatty acids. Now, fish also rich in vitamin A and D. Also, some fishes, they will provide other vitamins and minerals. But it's a fish liver is a fair source of vitamin B12. Okay, this is about fish. The ninth group is fat and oils. The ninth one is fat and oil. Now, fat and oil commonly we are using in a food preparation, which help us to give a different texture and taste to our food. Now, we Indians, not only our fat and oil, we are also using ghee to prepare a food item. In a cooking, we are using a ghee. Now, different kind of vegetable oils are used to prepare these items. Now, these fats are available in a solid form in a room temperature, and oils are in a liquid form in room temperature. Like we are having coconut oil, groundnut oil, mustard oil, sunflower oil, palm oil. See, from the different seeds, different nuts, we are using a different kind of oils. Now, very important, oil will provide some kind of energy, like 1 gram of oil will provide 9 kilocalories of energy. More than that, it provides a taste to the food item what we are preparing. Also, some vegetable oils will be rich in MUFA and FUFA. Also, they contain some essential vitamins and minerals. Now, apart from that, a very important thing that only is taste. Definitely, once you prepare your curry, if you give one seasoning with the oil, definitely the taste and a smell, everything get taste. That will change so that it will be more tasty. The 10th one is sugar and starchy food. This is mainly for preparation of a sweet. It gives a sweet taste to a food. Yeah, a sweet taste to a tongue buds. Okay. Now, the main types are sugar, jaggery, honey and custard. Now, sugar, it is prepared with the help of sugarcane. This jaggery is prepared with the help of sugarcane. Honey is mainly prepared by bee. This is only the food item which we can use, which is prepared by insects. Now, next is custard. It is a rich source of starch and also some quantity of minerals and vitamins. So, this is about sugar and starch food item. The last one is 11th one, condiments and spices. Definitely, we are not using it in a major quantity, but definitely we are using it a small proportionate, mainly to get a different taste and texture for a preparation what we are preparing. The different example of condiments are coriander, jeera, turmeric, chili powder, pepper, cardamom, cumin, garlic, mustard, etc. Definitely we want it in a small quantity. That small quantity is more than enough to bring the aroma and the taste. So dear students, I hope you understood. It's really a long topic where we discussed about 11 food groups. 11 food groups. Let me repeat once again. I would like to tell you what all the 11 groups are. Cereals and millets, pulses, nuts and oil seeds, vegetable, fruits, milk and milk product, egg, animal food, fat and oil, sugar and starch, and last one is condiments and spices. And I hope you understood, and I'll see you in the next class with the 5 group system. Thank you all.